started photographing in 2009 when we made the project with our students in Berlin. And I was very impressed by the work that Chipperfield had been doing in the Noyes Museum. And that was one of the elements that fascinated me, how, for example, this and most of the statues and pieces that are in the museum are really on that place. Like Julian under that cupola, it was really impressing me. And I went back today to the museum and it's still worth visiting. I'd like to see the entrance already, but I'll have to come back because they are not yet out, really out of the ground. Well, I will be talking about houses in a certain way. I will first do a house in the middle of a landscape, and that's a landscape near the seaside in Holland, just over the border from Belgium. And it's a landscape of plots where farmers are working on, and then some places where housing are just little plots in there. And one of that plots was, in fact, a farm, the old farmhouse was standing near to a dike, and it had a big, big barn. And it's an old photograph of the area. And one of the things was that the house was in very, very bad state, and it was having his facade on the dike and his back to the barn, in fact. Around it was water. Around it, and big orchids. And, well, for this project we could work together with the Wellstones Commission. It's an aesthetic commission in Holland. And the first question, because we had to go different times to discuss with them, together with Brian, the first discussion we had with them was where can we build if we want to take another place than the existing house. And they were, well, they said it depends on how you will do it. And we did choose for the orchid a place in the middle of the orchid, looking over the garden side, having a connection with the big barn and away from the dike, and looking to the south side. And then we had to think about what can we build next to such barn. And the big barn was so impressive that we were looking for all kinds of examples, historically seen what's belonging to a former place. And well, we had a kind of the barns as well in Germany, the higher barns, then you have this kind of and then we had an example of that one was no longer existing, in fact, but in the place just next door of a farm with a town. And we came with that example to the commission. And then we made a lot of models, and sketches and ideas together, and we went from time to time to discuss about it with the commission, and they did agree. And here you can see what was the result of it. So we had it.
Mama.
You enter along the barn, and then here you turn around the barn and you can see the house. And the idea of the house was the heavy tower with a lighter volume between the living area. And the tower was also a very good idea because of the foundations we needed. And we made a very simple plan of tower. So you have here somewhere that tower-like volume. And the connection between all the levels is the chimney. And the chimney is divided on the ground floor between sitting and dining room, and kitchen, and the right corner. And in fact, well, you enter the house from here, and you have a first already in the building before you really go in by that room. And then you have the kind of between room before you have to split in the two different areas. We wanted to make the house from 80 centimeters higher. That was the existing level of the old house. So because in red times the water level on the ground can become at that high. Then the rest of the tower is very simple. There is a staircase around the small elevator and the bathroom. Master bedroom, and the upper floor was first concept as a library and working area, but then having, and meanwhile has two children, so we have to change the upper floor, and then we can continue to get on the rooftop. And from where out you have a bit of view till the seaside. And the dear, that idea of the living room moving over that garden, taking the sun in fact, and the tower rising up. And well, from time to time I will show you all the things that were reflections or has been translated in detailing or ideas about thinking on some kind of a project or place. But in fact, for every facade, there was the idea that of the tower, that there were little openings, and then one big element has a big window overlooking the garden side or overlooking the landscape. That's the staircase turning around to the elevator. This is the staircase to the elevator and the last stop of the elevator. And so you go from the landscape from the top left on the outside. And then for the material is very important for the work. In a certain way to make it from the side, the surrounding, and all the other barns in the area, you see the photograph, there are made of wood, black painted wood, and around the windows they are making white painted contour. And that's what we did translate, in fact, in a new kind of form in this building, and that the Tao being strong and solid is also somewhere reminding of the work of Nina Bobardi's and our example. So here you can see the black wood, and then the second part of the sliding window is white painted here. There are some kind of elements white painted. And well, it was a sketch of the whole development of the ground floor, just the design of covers, becoming a cover for your laundry, becoming a window, and then becoming doors, and then becoming windows, cupboards, and then a kitchen. Staircase, you look through that window and look to the yard. Here you have one transparent glass that's looking at the entrance porch. This is the best side sun that's coming into the house. And as we go on to the pages, that's impressive. Because of his quality and because of how he can manage to make an idea of calmness, freedom, yes, being calm and very soft and nice place and taking care of light and his way of looking at things. Now we are in Ghent. Here we are in the more town landscape, and that's in fact my house over there. That's another house I've been in some years ago. That's one of the first houses I've been, and now we are visiting with this one, and we are doing the check for the corner. It is very difficult to get the burden for, and it was the same for this house to get the burden for. Here you can see the old houses that were built. Nowadays, they, I think, couldn't manage anymore to break them down. But I came to live in this one. And it was in a very bad state, so when I was a student, I just tried to make some masonry and carpentry, and I did put new windows, I made myself, I did it with my father and my brother to make it livable. But at a certain moment, I could buy, and I had to buy four of them at once, when the owner of the street, all the houses, in fact, his son died. He wanted to get off of his properties, and at that moment, the possibility to buy that four houses. And I've been working on the project for many years because it's very difficult to make your own house. I had no program, in fact, so I had to create my own program, and it's always very easy to ask a client about what do you want, what do you need, but for yourself you have needs. and there was also not so much time to work on it. It was only on holidays, especially that time when we went to Italy, it took with me a good through plans and started to make a program. came out of that one, and to continue the profile of the street, and made some kind of recto verso, full and open, but taking the rhythm of the workmen's houses that were already in the street, and also in the materialization. I didn't want to make something that was showing I was the architect. So the only thing I wanted to do is having an entrance that's already somewhere in the house. But the problem was that our commission didn't want to hide the windows. They found that there should be windows at that height. So they found it very, I was not very kind to the street, that people couldn't look in. And I said that they can recommend it already in the house when they are coming. And a colleague of me said, but in the evening, when there is light, all the others have been taking all the shutters down and closed windows, and here is light coming in that old street. And after a lot of discussion, I've got my permit. That's one of the sketches, a lot of sketches I made during holidays. Stairs have been moving from one side to the other side, but to the right you have the present. At least I dreamed of one thing, because the house where I live in had a very low ceiling and I wanted a high ceiling and a lot of light. With more than one door, because there were four houses before, so at least I had two doors, and I made the back door that works as well. In the meantime, it can work as a kind of, it should be a house, but you can do just something else. You can make an upper part that's independent from the ground floor. The gallery idea is from inside, in half outside, and then from outside, and the light is working in that room. And then there is a library. See, there are different staircases. As to do it, I think that I don't like that, and so I try to continue to walk through the house. And then that's the upper floor that can be affected if one is on. It's now for the moment, two sleeping rooms. Window frames, metal, and details of not making panels to open, so to make the metal outside by this, and the inside it's the metal frame that has been made. You can see what you do is the idea of making a white ceiling on the lower part of the gallery and then having the black ceiling on the higher. Having a double view from one side, inside the street. And here we are in Antwerp. In Antwerp there are different things. Museum plane. It's a place in front of the museum. And then there is the monuments. You have Modenazi. It was a fashion museum, and I was selected out of three architects. We had to make a project, but we made a book with the people who had to design in the existing building. And the transformation of this. It's kind of uniform that, well, in Antwerp at a certain moment they started to make some big lanes with trees and make open the city in connection to the medieval part, and that's why we have different corners that V-form. With the history of the building, it just had more allure years before. It was constructed as a hotel with rooms upstairs. And in the meanwhile, it had become, in fact, this. But it looks rather remarkable because when you are in that street, you can see the cathedral. That's very important. And one of the implications was that the whole building has been closed up by all kinds of levels during the years, and the idea was to open again that center in that V form and make kind of street lighting, but just the street coming in and moving up to all the facilities that are in the building. And it starts with a very big staircase to end up in a smaller one. On the ground floor, you have the real entrance to the lobby. And then at the first floor, there is the museum. It is the first floor, and there you have the entrance of the museum, a big platform, kind of piazza for entering the museum, and then you go higher up, and then you have here a platform with the library and the administration of the museum, and another flight of stairs going another way to go to the academy, the Fashion Academy, the Atelier, where they are doing their creation work. And I show this staircase because I had the idea that it's like walking. It was to walk up the stair, but having a look back to where you come from. So when you're on the highest platform, you still can look down and see where you come from. So it's a real open area with daylight coming in from the top. It's a heavy structure. And different areas on that staircase and platform. That's inside the museum. It's the V-form, the colonnades. We have to bring all the old structures and make some new interior. That's the wooden in wood, completely in mambo. So we wanted to make a light construction, like coming in that old construction. And on top we have the one of the ateliers for the city. And then we are back again in Ghent. In Ghent with the monuments we have. A lot of tourists coming from that row of towers. First competition in 1992 something on that place. And the question was to make a parking site and a place over it. And he was not to make parking, but to make a place for a roof and make a kind of a garden like for the green. Coming to the St. Glass Church. And in that in between level, underneath, we made at that time kind of a garage where we have an elevator to go down, but no one intentions to break a parking. And we were jumped out because we didn't answer the question really. But after half a year, the people of Ghent referendum with the question yes or no for parking, and they didn't want to park. But that didn't mean that we had the project. Yes, already in our office when the competition. It took some 6 years before they made the question anew what to do with the area. And now they did not longer the parking, but board fee, and that was the new question. And we have a lot of discussion about the building. That's all. Even that taken off the model they had taken off the building, and they asked us if we should agree with nothing on it. And we said that it's one of the most important things to restore something of the old type of building. And here you have, you can see the church and all the buildings that were existing before, because there were left two places here and there. And we wanted to restore it by making new buildings. And that building is the purple one. That's very balanced in between all that monuments, so that it creates views that are very logic. It has been moving just bit by bit, and trying out a lot of sketches and models. Such a group that we start, in fact, to make the study of the historical references by photographs of plants, just to make the context of what should be new, should be real, should be sensible. That's, in fact, that Tony Park was one of the elements we wanted to restore, but give it some more space. And meanwhile, the building is on the crossing of those places, and this green is surrounded by a path with staircases going to the old level of the city. And then there was the idea of this very impressed by trips and studying Italian architecture, because there were examples to make combinations of years and years of architecture of all kinds of ages. And we were, well, here you can see the Parma, all that elements that makes a kind of townscape. That's what we have been trying to find the new Stadthalle as well. It was our aim here, kind of meeting place for everybody, and it's well, because there's a lot of things to do. Again, we have a lot of feasts and music festivals, and everything that happens. That's the idea of the gate group is not only from that statue, artistic work, but we have it on the side around the facade of Down hall and all the buildings in the neighborhood. Here you can see how we just managed with the levels, with the old level, to make a kind of it's a restaurant and bicycle parking by moving. First, we made this one more horizontal, and this one. Underground that's coming above ground, and it gets the afternoon sun all the time in the afternoon. construction of the building, of course, was very important because we have four pillars and 40 meter span. And we've been working with Jaspa making that structure. And that structure is picking metal that's gathered inside the oak, outside with buffer material and glass panel. Then there was the, well, that's we did not have the competition that we have made bigger openings, but at the end we only made a fine like this openings, so it's like the kind of music light. And the glass paneling is taking the sun is gone and not it's taking the color of the sky. And then at night it's very inside out. Something very precious between all that historical buildings. If you're thinking what kind of place you're working on, you really feel like very responsible for it. And it has been, we have been studying very deep everything into the there is the importance of the fireplace. It was very important for us to make kind of a place where people could come together. Chimney and fireplace is the most house-like element you can have to people. In fact, that air is giving every New Year a drink. It was ideal that the mayor should invite all the young people for the meeting to under that. I think this is, well, that's for Robert. Some of you have been at the office and did this on our trip to Brazil. But we are working together mostly for the family area. And from time to time we are going to visit and look at things on the road. Just to fill our memory with the ideas. And that's the people who are working at my office, because without them, I shouldn't be here. I'm making a sketch, but they are really working on the project. We are in a time that we cannot do it anymore alone. Because the complexity of even architect is getting more and more. Your group. And, well, I have inspiration coming from male architects, but I want to show female. A woman who has been influenced me, whom I respect a lot for what they have been doing. And maybe some of them you will know. Marine Wiesgottheim. She has been for my. She's been very important for my. At the end of my studies, I've been doing a script on Gardner. And to give now time to talk till Nika talks. I didn't go further. I didn't go to the moment of the dance. Gardening, but I've been reading it in German, but I've lost my German today. But it took me months to read that two books on the Geschichte der Gartenkunst. But it has been very important to reflect on landscape and gardening. She made in the south of France. It's really a new view on the relation with the landscape around and the outside area around the house. And Vita Sati West is right there. She is also, she made Sissinger's garden. So Sissinger's garden is a system of different gardens which has each other sense. And then Charlotte Pignon, who has been working for most of the interiors and sitting for Paul Bussier. She was a very courageous woman to work for him. Louise Bourgeois is the artist. She has been making a lot of artistic work, so with her hands and her phone, she has her hands very beautiful. And then Lina Bobardo, I'm showing you when she worked in Brazil. And Cristina Iglesias, that's an artist of Spain, who has been working, she made the fountain. Museum place, and she made a fountain on the idea of collage from Greece in concrete, and it's a bas-relief where water is coming up out of the gap and then is going down, and it takes the time for a visit at the museum. And she has been making also a roof in the exhibition. She's very able to make, as an artist, work that's very connected to architecture. It shouldn't be so, it don't need to be autonomous. She really wants to make work that belongs to the architecture. And as Lisa Moller, she's from Chile, and she is a landscape architect who's doing with very little elements, making, evaluating, making on a higher level the landscape, can be staircases around rocks, can be a path, can be very small things she's using to, so that you really see what the landscape is. And then, another public place, it's in Leinze, it's from 20 kilometers from Ghent, but along the same river, Leyer, as the river. We have a new channel. And the market is that long stripe here. That was becoming a kind of parking place, and it had lost all this identity. And there was the question to make a new concept for this, even a new relation with the park behind, a new relation with the borders of the lake. How it is being marketed. It's very used, let's say, by all kinds of cycling. There is a market every week, there is a special horses market. Here, here again, it inspired us on the material for the place. And it had been always kind of marketplace from one facade to the other. And one of that elements was it had a very long, the idea of being very long. And we wanted to give the monuments, the important buildings that were on the place, this one, we wanted to give them an identity in that flat area. And the first thing was the church. And then there was the town hall with the library. Will move very soon here. And then there was an old belfry, hallway, that was kind of, a small building in red stone, where the old foundation was left. And we had with a new roof on it. So you can have again the idea of being halfway and have another part. So it makes it more, it gives you an idea of distance when you walk over the market. And then the last one is the connection to the park side, where you do this, and you continue again the market. And one of the ideas was to do it with things of the Sint Maarten Zlatum, there's a group of painters of the 1900, and they were all painting their own environment, giving it the name of winter, summer, and so on. So we did choose them for the colorist together with the colorist, who did make the drawings of the princess. And with the drawings, we have been designing concrete colored stones that very short when it has to do about one or two proteins that one. And I wanted to show because it's how we work with the difficulty of the scarce place we have to construct them. This is not plot in near Mechelen. And there's a holiday place, and this was an old camping site. And that camping site has been, it was no longer in use since a long time, and meanwhile the trees have been growing very well. And although it has the capacity of being for urbanism, it should be a kind of an area where can be constructed. And well, one of the difficulties, or one of the ways we wanted to work on that area was to make a study of all the important trees on the plot and then try to link it together with the idea of 17 houses that could be constructed on it. And that's all. Mm-hmm. We did give all the important to these numbers so that we can work them down. And that's what the idea of first getting was something very rather very strict about getting 70 houses. There was kind of a already kind of urbanistic plan who told us yes, there we should have individual houses. And it started to make some kind of laws that we knew already where were the most important trees, for example, here along the roadside. Here was some kind of important trees in there. So we made first a straight drawing, and then we went back by our numbered trees to give kind of a move in that street line of the enter here, so we have here a big book. As well, so we moved with the street, so every street becomes belonging to that, that's a red birch, and it's then here in the book again. So every time that trees were making that plots belonging to that area. And we got 70 houses on it, or you can see still some trees that will not be fit. But it wanted to make those two layers, bring those two layers together. And that's what we did present also, because here are some, and they wanted to make that street larger. And we did propose to make the walking and cycling area in between that trees, so we don't have to take them off. That was our discussion, because we had a lot of problems with neighbors who wanted to have the whole block no longer constructed. And they have to, they were a bit astonished of the way we had been treating the project, because they thought that everything should be done. Good examples for making housing. And then that's the last house, and that's a house in something in between, and it was very, very difficult. With a lot of complications because of the the contour is just moving all the time from left to right, and at the left side here this house has windows looking on the garden, and the house before was standing here, and we did want to make part of the house deeper. So we had at least the garden as a viewpoint, but there was a lot of discussion of urbanism. We had to make a house really do this, and then we had to put the garage there because everybody has garages in the side. And that made it still more difficult because we had to keep 1 meter. This, we should have to be an entrance going to the parking lot, and we had a whole building at the street side, mm-hmm. the south side, at the front. Mm-hmm. We have been making models try to convince what the how to organize a house, because it's not only a house with a family with three children, but also with the woman is a psychiatrist for the children. So we made at the front side, we made the cabinet.
Thank you. I Mm-hmm.